So here's what's left of the original test, prototype, build, whatever you want to call it. Here's what's left of the original Franken truck. Franken truck's getting an upgrade. Franken truck's getting some changes made. Gonna get rid of the pan. Gonna get rid of all this suspension. Gonna do all kinds of stuff. Still gonna use the drive and the motor setup. Still gonna use the same ESC and receiver and the same steering servos. But everything else is going away. Let's get started. First thing I'm gonna do is get all this stuff out of the way and start cleaning up these parts. Or what? Drive shafts. Need this. Nice tight tolerance. Let's see if we can get this inside one in now. Get the inside one in. In all the way. It's a little too big. Okay. And this goes out through there. Just like that. Ta-da! Okay. Now, before I forget, Now this is open somewhere, I don't remember where. This is the grease for all these parts. All these gears gotta have grease on them. When they go together. Okay, that part's done. Now this part. The oh joy, what fun part. Pin goes through the center here, like so, and this shaft gets a grease seal on it, which is really weird that the other ones don't, but this one does. And it goes down in there. And this doesn't get bearings either, which is kind of strange. But it does get grease seals. So that's just, I don't know, kind of weird. Let's put a little grease on that. So, grease on the grease seal, and drop it down. And these stubs are identical, so it doesn't matter which one goes in which way. Okay, now this goes on here like this, and then this one goes on here like this. 10-4. So put a little bit of grease on all this stuff. This one on here. Okay. Nice. Now we need to put a little grease on that. take much. Just a little dab will do. Okay. Then we drop that down in like so. There's a small slot for the pin and a larger slot for the bracket. That all has to go together. Like so. And when these turn, they'll circulate that grease around there. Okay. Then this gets a gasket put on it, lined up with the holes, like so. Set that somewhere. Kind of like that. Then we take this, we put this on here. Nope, sorry. Put this on here. Put a little grease on that shaft. Just for good measure. On the gear that can actually get put on now. Okay, and the grease seal. Don't want to forget that. Right there. Okay. Perfect. Alright. Put that on there. And there's little pins, I think, that line this up. Don't take much. Just a little bit, because we already got a lot of grease on this gear in here, so that makes it okay. Put the bearings on it, Yep, it gets bearings. Everything in this build has roller bearings in it. That goes in there, and that drops down in there, just like that. And just like magic, what do we got going on here? I have that upside down. Ah, I did. Okay, now put this half on. Is that the right way? Yep, look at there. Perfection. Getting grease prints all over it. Ah! Now we can start the rest of the assembly. Almost forgot something. I have to attach the axles, because these get a little tiny pin with threads on the end, and they get put in to this thing here like so. Line the hole up. Like so. And this goes through. So you get a solid pin all the way through the coupling. Ow! And the axle itself. Thread that in until it's about flush, and when you roll it over, it's about flush, so you know you're good to go. Let's get the other half on there. Get it lined up. Okay, now we can put the back half on. Just like that. Then, make sure this turns free. Put these in just to double check everything. And return. Which it does. These will turn individually of each other. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you.